Hey y'all, this is Marshawn Olanio, and we are back out here for day number 16 on how to improve your relationship by 3X. Today we're going to talk about how to become the giver. Yes, become the giver in your relationship. I know that you're probably thinking, I can hear some of you guys already, oh boy. Become the giver. I'm not saying give to the point where you're feeling like your husband, your boyfriend. Hey Omar, I finally, okay, thank you. Facebook is not telling me that you are online, and every time I get off here, I always see that you are on or online or have watched the video. So they finally notified me that you are on here. So welcome, Omar. Okay. So getting back to becoming the healer, I know that some of you guys are like, oh boy, I got it. Oh man, I'm already giving, right? Hey Sylvia, I see you. Thanks for watching. Becoming the giver in your relationship is all about specifically at this point. You've gotten to this point because you need a healing in your relationship. You need some more structure in your relationship. You need some guidance in your relationship. And so I'm guiding you through today to tell you to start becoming the healer in your, to start becoming the giver in your relationship. Hey, sis, I see you. Hey, Galena. Hey. I get to see you in a minute. In 2 weeks, I get to see you in person. So anyway, getting back to becoming the giver in your relationship. You have to start to become the giver in your relationship because, again, your relationship did not get to this point just out of the blue. It took a while for your relationship to need the healing that it needs currently. So you have to start becoming the giver in your relationship. You have to start becoming the giver on a consistent basis. I keep talking about consistency because consistency matters. You have to become the giver in order to start to heal your relationship. You have to become the giver because you need to start the process of healing your relationship. Hey Gia, welcome back. You always watching, so thank you for watching. Thanks for coming back. One of the things that you want to do when you are starting to give in your relationship is to give without expectation. Yes, give without expectation, because again, you are creating this newfound relationship. You're creating this newfound foundation to your relationship. And so again, you want to create that consistency. You want your partner to see that you are willing to give, that you are willing to work, that you are willing to do what you need to do in order to get the relationship back on track. So at this point, and actually from now on, but specifically to healing your relationship, getting your relationship back on track, you need to give without expectation, specifically to your spouse. Give without expectation to start that healing process in your relationship. Because a lot of times, actually I have to say, every time that I've done it, and every time I talk to people who've done it, which is anytime you give, anytime you are giving without expectation specifically, and you put others first, whether it's intended or not, things just start to happen. Miracles start to unfold in your relationship specifically to this topic. So anytime I decide to give without expectation, it actually works. It changes the dynamic and the relationship all around. It changes the dynamic in your relationship all around. So start to give without expectation so you can get this healing that you need in your relationship, so you can change your relationship all around, so you can improve your relationship by 3X. Hey Alicia, hey, I see you, honey. welcome. I've been wondering where you at, honey. So yeah, thank you for showing up, okay? When you start to give without expectation, you actually already gained everything that you need because you're not expecting anything. And so if you are giving, if you are in a state of giving, putting yourself out there without thinking about receiving anything, then you already won. You've already won if you just give to just give. And giving with a full heart truly shows that you love yourself. You also believe in your worth, and you're doing it just to give so much more to your spouse. Specifically in this situation, you are giving to your spouse. Now, what does giving look like? Giving could be anything. Giving could be, you know what? I was pissed off at him or I was pissed off at her, and I'm not cooking their food. I'm not serving them. And so instead of you thinking that way, You switch it all around, and then you say, you know what, today I am going to just serve my spouse no matter what, no matter the attitude that they give you. This is a no matter what situation, because you're trying to change your relationship completely around. Completely around. This is a way to start changing your relationship completely around. Giving without expectation. You're also going to give because you want your spouse's life just to be better. Yeah, you want your spouse's life to be better. When you start to give without expectation, your life can be nothing but better. Your life can be nothing but better. So you are making sure that your spouse's life is better. Hey, Renee, I see you. Thanks for watching. Give so your spouse feels better about their life. Again, you're going to feel better about your life. It's going to be a task right now because you're not used to doing it. At least some of you out here are not used to just giving in order to improve your relationship, because we're used to receiving. We're used to wanting. We're used to taking, or only doing it when you get something in return. But we're changing that habit. We are building a new foundation in our relationships. So we're going to give without expectation. We're going to give because it's going to make our spouse feel good. And at the end of the day, it's going to make you feel good too, because you're like, you know what, I actually did good today. This is a process. Changing and switching your relationship around is a process. It didn't go down the rabbit hole overnight. It will not come out of the rabbit hole overnight. This is consistency. Like I mentioned yesterday, this is a life challenge. Yes, I said that this is a 30-day challenge, but really, if you want your relationship to change, if you really want to have that blissful relationship, this is a life challenge. Alicia says, good stuff. I have to remind myself of walking these principles out. Thank you for the needed reminder. You are very welcome, Alicia. Very, very welcome. I need this reminder myself, okay? Because I'm used to giving to everybody. And by the time I get to the house, I halfway want to give to my spouse. So anytime I'm delivering these messages to you guys, I'm delivering them to myself too, because I'm still a work in progress too. I need to take my own advice, which I actually do. Anything that I'm on here saying to you guys, I do it myself. That's when you really need to give. When you don't feel like giving. Another thing, when you give, you automatically tell your mind and your heart that they are full, and you do not hold any ill will toward your spouse, any ill will toward the situation. You are ready to move on. You're ready to create this happy love story that you truly have been wanting. Hey, Alex, I see you. Thanks for watching. So, yes, these are some of the things that you need to think about. This is another thing that you need to start implement into your relationship. And so what can you do today to be a selfless giver to your spouse? One thing, just choose one thing today, and then choose another thing tomorrow, and then choose another thing the next day. Just one thing, one thing. Even if you know, I'm gonna use the dry cleaners. Do people still use the dry cleaners? Anyway, if you know that your spouse needs their clothing picked up from the dry cleaners, instead of you calling to have to ask, just go and pick up the clothes. You know that your spouse is sick and tired of doing the laundry, just fold the laundry today. Do something nice for your spouse, something that you know that they need. And if you know their love language, that's an even better way to give to them. You know that they like it, spending quality time. It doesn't matter if you're mad. Break the silence. Talk to your spouse. Spend quality time with them. You know that they like gifts. Go pick a flower. It doesn't have to be a bought gift. Go pick a flower. Break the silence. Go and say hello. Talk to your spouse. Give them something. It's a great surprise to be the receiver. Great surprise. It breaks the ice. It breaks down that emotional I'm holding on to. I'm going to be mad. It don't matter what you say. I'm being mad. It breaks it all down. Sis, it breaks it all down. Bruh, it breaks it all down. I am a knower in that one. I'm a knower and a believer, because it happens. I get broken down when I want to listen. I'm a work in progress. God's still working on you, girl. I'm a work in progress. So sometimes I want to hold on and be ignorant myself, even though I have the knowledge. All of us have the knowledge. We're just not doing what we need to do with the knowledge. Become the giver in your relationship so you can change your relationship all around. All right, does that make sense to you guys? I'm glad that it does. Thanks for watching today, and I will be back out here for day 17 tomorrow. All right, y'all have a wonderful, blessed, beautiful day, and go be the giver. What are you going to do today? One thing. What are you going to do tomorrow? One thing. What are you going to do the next day? One thing. To become the giver in your relationship. All right, I'll see y'all tomorrow.